In this second video, I'm going to extend the game we developed in the first version of Craps and turn it into a game where the game can be played over and over again with the player either winning or losing money. Let's show you how this game works. If I execute this program, it asks me if I wish to play Craps. We'll decide to play. So this time it tells me I've started with $100. My wager is $5 on each game. And in this case, of course, this is randomly generated. The point is 7. I win that particular round, and I now, of course, my balance goes up to $105. Obviously, I'm happy to have won that, so I would like to play again. I rolled a 3 and a 5. The point is 8. So we'll keep rolling the dice. In this case, the total is 7. You may remember that if a 7 comes up before the 8, the player loses. I'm now back to having $100 available because I lost the $5 I made previously. And let's play this one more time. So we'll play again. I rolled a 2 and a 3. The point is now 5. I'll roll the dice. I got a 4. I'll roll again. Again, a 7 came up before a 5, so I just lost again. I'm now down to $95. Okay, I'm not very happy about that, so I'll decide not to play again, and it asks, thanks me for playing the game, and I'll press enter to quit. Okay, so what changed in the program here? Well, the greeting stayed, a lot of the functions stayed exactly the same. We'll notice that abort program remained the same. We'll also notice that the greeting remained the same. It asked me if I wanted to play the game of craps. But the thing that really changed here is this function called, I've added a function called play game. And play game plays one game of craps, and it returns a Boolean result, either true or false, depending on whether the player wins or not. So play game returns true if the player wins, and it returns false if the player loses. And it handles all the logic for playing a game. Roll a die, as before, handles the logic for rolling a die. And so the main program here handles the betting logic and the user interface. So if we look at int main, you'll see that it deals with all of the logic that has to do with betting and whether the player wants to play again. But once the player decides to play a game, then the play game function appears right here. So if the user decides to play a game, we're going to call this function play game. Remember, that function returns either true or false. If the player plays the game successfully, we'll increment the player's account by 5. And if the player if the player loses the game, will decrement the player's account by 5. So what we've really done here with this structural breakdown is in the program main, we're handling the user interface logic to the game. This is a function which really handles all of the dialogue with the user as the game goes on. The logic of the game itself and the rules of craps are encapsulated in this function called play game. There's the logic to actually play the game. The logic to roll a die and see if you get a 1 through 6 and so on is encapsulated in that function. And the logic to sign on and determine if the player wishes to play the game or not is encapsulated in that function. So the idea of breaking this game up into several different functions is really to make sure that the design concept here is to make each function as independent and autonomous as possible. If we want to change how dice gets rolled, we'll just change this function and hopefully not have to change anything else. If we want to change the rules of how craps gets played, we'll change the play game function and potentially not everything else. And if we want to change the user interface, hopefully all we have to do is look in the function main and not change anything else. So we've broken a relatively complicated application up into its independent constituent components. And the idea is to make each one of those as easy to service and maintain as possible. Thank you.